Dave Grimes has asked us how to go about painting horses, so in this video we're going to show you how to do a dark brown one. And to do it, you need a base coat of Rhinox hide first of all, then we're going to layer it using Doomball Brown. Then we'll shade all over with Agrax Earthshade, and if you want to add any darker patches of hair, we'll do that then with Norn Oil. After that, we're going to highlight it using Tusk or Fur. But starting with Rhinox hide, I'm going for a medium base brush for this, and as always, make sure you use your palette to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth, so just a small amount of water into the mix there like that. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this base coat. For this example, I'm going to focus just on the front of this horse here just to show you what to do. But of course, repeat this on all the rest of the horse, whichever miniature you're doing. Next, apply a layer of Doomball Brown using a medium layer brush. And for this, what you're looking to do is to paint the flatter areas and still leave Rhinox hide showing in the recess parts. So you can see on this leg here how I'm following on the muscle just to build up that highlight there like that. Now you do the exact same thing on the mane and the tail. Next, bring those colours together by applying a coat of Agrax Earthshade all over the horse using a medium shade brush. At this point, if you want to add any darker markings to your horse, you can do so using Norn Oil. And this will be markings around, say, the muzzle or on the legs. And if you want them to be darker, then you can apply a second coat once the first one's dry. And finally, apply a highlight using Tusk or Fur, following along all the most defined areas of the muscle. So, for example, on the leg, just following along these edges here like I'm doing just now. But also be sure to highlight all of the mane and the tail by just using the side of your brush to lightly catch the raised areas. And with that highlight done, the majority of the horse's body is done, and all you've got to do is paint in all the remaining details like the saddle and all that kind of thing. So Dave, I hope that answers your question. We'll see you all again very soon.